So it's going right now. What's up, y'all? All praises to Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai. Double honors to the apostles of Great Millstone. We out here in Columbus, Ohio, and we just going to bring this fruit out, see what happens.
Spirit take over.
Like it always does. Yeah, we ain't coming right here with a lesson plan.
Luke 18:1. He spoke a parable unto them to this end, that men ought always to pray and not to faint. Then there was in the city a judge which feared not God neither regarded men, but was the good of in that city. And he came unto him saying, "Avenge me of my adversaries." And he would not for a while, but afterward he said, returning himself, "So I fear not God nor regard men. Because this build up troubleth me, I will avenge her by her continual coming to bury me." And the Lord said, "Hear what the unjust judge said. And she shall not God avenge his own elect?"
Yeah, so now God, the Most High, avenged the nation of Israel, his elect. You know what I'm saying? You see how we get treated in this country.
Oh,
that's good. That ain't nothing. So the Lord is going to avenge the, it looks like that scripture in Revelation had the cry of the saints who went up to the heavens, or something, he avenges, you know what I mean? You know where that said? The blood of the saints, something like that. Yeah, so we cry to the Most High day and night. You know what I mean? Because we living fucked up out here. There ain't shit good about living out here in this palace shit called America. It's all bad. No, nothing is good. Go ahead, bring that up.
It's Revelation 17:6. And I saw the woman drunken with the blood of the saints.
Now the woman is talking about that great whore. She's drunken with the blood of saints. That's talking about America, that whore to ride up on the beast. You know what I mean? Go ahead.
And with the blood of martyrs of Yahweh Shai. And when I saw her, I wondered with great admiration.
Right, so right now, soon they gonna start coming after people teaching the truth. You heard that thing they got about fake news? All these,
saying, that's big right now,
yeah, too. Saying that unless you're like part of CNN or Fox or whatever, mm-hmm. that you can get possibly locked up for making videos like this, you know, bring out information. And you see, that's why there's no Bibles allowed in school. They got after-school Satan programs, but you're not allowed to have a Bible in the school. But they can have after-school Satan programs, and they can have Muslims walk around doing their prayers and shit in school. Wearing their little, what them shits called, the hapjids or whatever? What is the hip, whatever that heathen shit they be wearing on their head. And they be wearing the face and all that. Got their magic carpets. But they allow that shit in the school, but no Bibles though. They teach, you know, the Greek mythology. They teach Egyptian mythology, but no Bible. No Bible allowed. So that's how we know this is the kingdom of Satan. And soon, like, we're going to get to that hour of temptation. Because people might be like, ain't none of y'all getting killed right now. You know what I mean? But watch. Watch when they bring that Mark of the Beast and they start implementing the Mark of the Beast and people start coming against it. They're going to start putting people to death. And who's the main people teaching about the Mark of the Beast now? Because everybody talks about them. They claim they know about the microchip, the RFID technology. But who's the main people warning people about this? You know what I mean? It's us. They nobody else doing more work than us, warning people about the Mark of the Beast. You got more to that?
Yeah, and the angel said unto me, "Wherefore didst thou marvel? I will tell thee the mystery of the woman and the beast that carried her, which has the 7 heads and 10 horns. The beast that thou sawest was, and is not, and shall descend out of the bottomless pit."
Well, that's the point right there, because it went into the, you know, because the Lord's going to avenge his saints, you know what I mean? His elect. You got more to that one? That was a good scripture, though.
I tell you that he will avenge them speedily. Nevertheless, when the Son of Man cometh, that he find faith on the earth.
Oh yeah, so the Lord is going to find faith on the earth. You know what I mean? as the elect, a very small percentage of people who actually know they got the faith, they're doing the work. That's not a lot of people. That's why the Lord said, many are called, but few are chosen. There ain't a whole lot of people gonna make it. Most of y'all ain't gonna make it. How you think you gonna make it? We out here telling people not to celebrate Christmas because that's what the Bible says. And we telling everybody Christmas is devil worshiping, which it is. And you tell them week in, week out, year in, year out, tell the same people that don't celebrate Christmas, they still keep doing it. So you gonna tell me they gonna get saved?
No.
Nah, you ain't making it. And that's most people. They ain't gonna give up their Christmas. So that, that's part of that pride of life. You know what I mean?
When they get the ham too.
Yeah, they gonna give that. They don't want to give up the pork.
And honey baked ham.
They don't give it up. You tell Israelite he's not allowed to eat pork. He might want to fight you.
Mm-hmm, right.
You know what I mean? They are pork ambassadors.
All this other good shit the world gave us is education.
Yeah, the tasty food is endless. There's so much tasty food. And you know, most of the tasty the snacks is all vegetarian. Chocolate, you know, snack food. It's not even meat at all. Yeah, honey. Oh, that's the real shit right there, honey. If you can find some real honey.
Oh, yeah. The real honey will find this fitted shit. It ain't been heated and refined.
Yeah.
That's a good honey.
Straight out the beehive.
The ones that ain't been heated up and jarred and made that liquefied honey, it lasts longer. It lasts and stretches longer. You don't need as much honey. Yeah, honey.
Hey, that's why the Lord said the land of Israel is known as the land of milk and honey.
Mm-hmm.
The land of plentiful. You know what I mean?
Yeah, these motherfuckers don't want to give up that money back down.
Yeah, because
of
I wish you could just get the scripture. Because you can't never read the law enough.
Yeah, my friend, man, the bitch that teaches Bible study for us, she was like, I just can't do it. I just can't give up my book. Okay.
Leviticus. Let me get wait till this go by. Shit's loud, man.
Yeah, people can't discipline themselves. You know. They can't discipline themselves.
Shit's so greasy.
You tell these, ask one of these motherfuckers to fast for the Lord, man.
Oh, hell no.
No water, no food. That's what the fuck, hell no. I can't, I can do everything else, but not that.
They can't go for 12 hours fast.
Hell no. 3 hours.
They got no control over themselves.
Right.
No, like you said, no discipline. Leviticus 11:7. And the swine, though he divided the hoof and be cloven footed, yet he cheweth not the cud, he is unclean to you. Of their flesh shall ye not eat, and their carcass shall ye not touch. They are unclean to you. So the scriptures clearly say that you ain't supposed to eat pork. People think that's like a Muslim thing. That's a Bible thing.
You got something?
Go ahead.
Rock 29 and
25. I got a power scripture too. Who the hell wants to be sick, you know? Who wants to be clogged up with shit? Sitting down, you gotta take a laxative just to take a fucking shit, you know?
That's why you see all these people, they get old, they all, you know, out of shape, they all wrinkly.
Hey, most of them don't even be old.
Yeah, they don't even be old, right?
They don't even be old.
Right, because all the people I went to school with, I went to high school with, I'm in my late 30s, right? Everybody I went to high school with, I look at them now, they look like they in their 60s.
They're aged.
I mean, they look aged. You know what I mean? And they all talking about how young I look.
Right. Go ahead.
30. And 14. Better is the poor being sound and strong of constitution and a rich man that is afflicted in his body. Health and good estate, a body are above all gold, and a strong body above infinite wealth.
Right, what good is it to benefit you? You got $1 billion, but you sick as fuck.
Right.
You barely walk.
You obese.
Yeah, right.
Out of shape, can't breathe.
All that money is doing is just contributing before you're getting worse and worse.
Yep.
You know?
And you're going to have a short life, so you ain't taking it with you.
Oh, unless you're a pharaoh, huh?
Well, you take it with you in the dirt. Until a grave robber comes and gets it.
There's no riches above a sound mind, a sound body. No joy above the joy of the heart. Death is better than a bitter life or continual sickness.
Yeah, continual sickness. If you're not eating right, you're going to be sick. If you're not getting enough sunlight, like nowadays, people did not get proper sunlight because they in their house all day on their computer or watching TV and then never getting outside, and they get sick. Yeah, you got to get sunlight. You got to eat right. You can't be eating no swine. And that's all in the scripture. You know what I mean? It tells you how to eat right. There's a reason.
That's right. That's right. This is Job 36 and 10. He openeth also the ear to discipline and commandeth that they return from iniquity.
Yeah.
It don't take much discipline not to eat no fucking pork.
Right.
Crab, lobster, shrimp.
Same with that, because, yeah, you got to have that discipline.
You know, discipline yourself not to just to eat. Just because a movie come on, I'm just going to go, let me put a plate up, a bowl of potato chips, you know, dip. All that fat and shit. Just because a movie come on.
Or candy, the football game. No,
right,
the
right,
football
right.
game come on, that's the real showdown.
Right. What they do, Christmas dinner, Thanksgiving dinner, they gluttonous, man. Just no control, man. Eat till they fucking sick, man. Just sick.
Making gigantic meals. You can't possibly eat all that food. And if they don't eat it, they throwing all kind of shit away, being wasteful as hell.
Right.
That's what you call, that's what you call decadent. Like towards the end of the Roman Empire, that's how people were living. They was living lavish, right. Having them giant dinners, you know what I mean? Just going, all, just being decadent.
Oh, shit. You saw how Caligula's dinners were.
Oh, yeah.
Woo!
Because America is the Roman Empire. It's the reincarnation of Rome. And it's going down just like Rome went down. When you see how Rome went down, what happened toward the end of Rome? What? Faggots were everywhere. The freak shows were everywhere. Trannies. Fucking.
Major sporting events.
Major sporting events to control the minds of the people.
Because wars everywhere.
Yep. Yeah, countless wars. Immigration. They had huge immigration problems, just like America. So America's on its way out. We almost at the end of America. It don't ran its course, all right? It don't ran its course. And Donald Trump ain't gonna make America great again. The Lord is gonna burn America with fire. And that's what's coming, is fire, flames. That is the good news.
That is the gospel. Just run its course.
That every 4 years they come at you with some bullshit. They had Obama coming at your ass with hope and change. You know, I mean, this was just some slogans, some catchy ass slogans.
Slogan? Yes, I can.
Yes, I can. Yes, we can.
Yes, we can.
Yes, we can.
And you put it backwards and said, "Hail Satan."
Thank you, Satan.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
Paul used to do it on the playbook.
Yeah. Good boy. Dude, he's going all out. He looked like like somebody off one of them fighting games on the PlayStation. One of them crazy looking characters.
Let go.
Fucking totally, he's out of there.
He got this girl right here.
I'll catch my saddle if I can.
You already know that.
Right.
She'll be driving down the street one day and her hair fly out the window. You be seeing weaves. I call them tumbleweeds. They be blowing in the wind down the street. They be all over the place. That's a damn shame. Hey, that's because the Lord cursed y'all women, man. That's why you can't grow no hair. Because y'all fucking whores. You're not following the laws and the commandments of the Most High.
They undisciplined dogs. Like
about this. So being a bald-headed bitch, that's the punishment of a wicked-ass hoe.
The undisciplined dog. They ain't got discipline to cover
their feet. The women, don't we want to talk about the men. The men have no discipline. So you're talking about the women, and they're way worse than the men. The word discipline is not in their vocabulary. At least the men can get disciplined to train for their football team or Madden or... What is the woman? She has nothing. She has none. No discipline. Just talking shit. Yeah. These women are out of order. Go ahead. Hopefully someone got shot right in their fucking head. Which one?
The black coat?
Yeah.
Okay. Lucy ain't calling something else.
Well, that's old.
Yeah, even Wu-Tang was using that one, yeah. What's good? What's up, Ike? What's up, guys? Remember they used to call each other God? Like, what's up, guys? I'll go ahead, bro. I got my girl.
I remember you guys.
How you doing?
What are you doing?
Yo, dressed up today.
I talked to you when I got off work.
Yeah, I remember you.
How are you guys doing?
She got done up for us today, didn't you?
Just getting off work.
I gotta go get the bus. I think
all right now. She looks like a totally different person. I'll notice it. She's one of those. Yeah. She's not all together.
Yeah, one day they look like a monster down here, the next day they're decent.
Yeah. That's crazy, boy. That's that facade these women got, you know? Hey, she was cool, though. She, last week, even though she don't have no clue what's going on, she knew about the Mark of the Beast, didn't she? What, who's talking to her about the Mark of the Beast?
I remember the bitch.
Yeah.
She was here last week?
Yeah.
Damn.
We talked to her 2 weeks ago or last week. I can't remember. But we was talking to about the Mark of the Beast with her, I think. She's like, oh, yeah, I know about that. Or something.
Hey,
go ahead,
bring your picture out. Isaiah 3:44. Over Yahweh says, because the daughters of Zion are haughty.
The daughters of Zion are haughty. What does the word haughty mean? We don't use that word no more. You know, they disrespectful. The women are loud. These women are loud. They're disrespectful. They got no manners. They got no decency. They walk around looking like whores and strippers. You know what I mean? Go ahead.
Walk with jerk force neck and watch your eyes.
And that's how they do it. They walk, you know, walk, they think they the shit. The women walk. Like I said, they dress like strippers already. So you looking at them already, you're like, damn, bitch. And then she thinks she's the shit. You got other men coming up giving her compliments on how good of a whore she is. You know what I mean? It's whacked out, man. Go ahead.
Walking and mentioning as they go, making a tinkling with their feet.
Because they know they the shit. You know what I mean? In their mind, they know they the shit. You know what I mean? You know, all these women, they think they're so special. They be on Facebook posting 500 selfies a day. From all angles, trying to get that perfect selfie. Just obsessed with their looks. See, that's all the woman's really into is the lust of the flesh and the lust of the eye. That's why it was so easy to trick the woman in the garden. When the serpent came up, the serpent tricked the woman and not the man.
Got him.
Because what did it say? The woman said when she seen the fruit, it was pleasing to her eye. Because that's what a woman likes, is something that's pleasing to her eye. You know what I mean? That's it.
Sounds good too.
Yeah, so it looks good, sounds good, smells good. She can only use the basic five senses. She ain't got that sixth sense. You know what I mean? Go ahead.
Therefore the Lord will smite with the staff in front of the head of the daughters of Zion.
The daughters of Zion. And this proves who the daughters of Zion is. Go ahead.
I will discover the secret places.
And the Most High will discover her secret places. Talking about a female's secret places. Go ahead. Well, just figure, what is that? Just think about it. Go ahead.
Too long to figure out.
But people are dumb though. They probably, I don't know. Go ahead. Let's talk about these women. Instead of sweet smell, go ahead.
There shall be stink.
And you can see that. That's why it's not even safe to have sex no more with a woman. You know what I mean? That's why they got that sell condoms. That's why that's a business. Because it's not safe. And you get up in there, boy, the shit don't smell too good. It's an awful thing to say, but it's the truth. Because these women have multiple sexual partners. By the time a woman turns 18, she done had sex with like 500 dudes. That's being conservative. By the time she's 18, she done had sex with a whole city. You know what I mean? So what do you think it's smelling like? And the Lord ain't no liar, okay? You hoes are liars. The Lord is not a liar. I didn't cheat on you. Go ahead.
Instead of a girdle and ring, instead of well-set hair and baldness.
Yeah, that's what you bald. That's why you bitches is bald. You. That's why they got a weave shop on every corner up in the hood. You know what I mean? You dumb bitches can't grow no hair. Go ahead.
Instead of a stomach full of girding of sackcloth.
I told you I had this girl too, bro. I was kicking away for a minute. I mean, she was cool though, whatever. But goddamn, she had a fade with zigzags in her shit, bro. Like, goddamn. So I can't even run my fingers through the hair. I gotta run my finger through the zigzag. You know what I mean? What kind of madness is that? You know how you like to play with a bitch's hair? Bitch can't grow hair. Go ahead.
And burning instead of beauty.
What your bitches got purple hair, got wearing purple hair, weaves that look like a Persian rug or something. You know what I mean? You seen them weaves? They look like balls of yarn. They wearing yarn. They just go get some yarn. Don't even get a weave. Just go get a ball of yarn and duct tape that shit to your head. You know what I mean? Yeah. You know cats that have a field day with that head. Don't let these bitches get around a cat. They be smacking the shit out of your weave.
That's what it is though, ain't it?
It look like yarn.
It does.
That's ridiculous, man. And they don't realize how stupid they look. You look better with just a little nappy ass hair than that dumb ass weave.
Damn, you would think a bitch that's supposed to be God would be better than that.
Oh, yeah,
she can grow hair. She's God.
Right, let this
grow. She don't need
a
man. She can use a barfing gland to give birth. If she can't grow hair, okay.
God.
She is God.
She's God.
The woman is God.
God of shit. God.
I wonder who the first dumbass to say that was.
Oh,
oh, there they go. They've blown their loud packs out here. You always smell like weed at the bus stop. Every keep going on that Isaiah. That Isaiah goes hard.
Isaiah 3:25. Thy men shall fall by the sword, and thy mighty in war, and her gates shall limit and mourn, and she, being desolate, shall sit upon the ground.
Right, because if like back in the ancient world, if the Most High was not with Israel, if Israel was being wicked and not following the commandments, doing what they was told, when they went into battle, they lost. Just like when, you remember when the Lord sent it, right after the Exodus, the Lord sent out spies to spy out the promised land, right? And a lot of the Israelites came back and they gave an evil report saying the Canaanites are too strong for us. So the Most High jacked them up. He said, I don't care how strong. I told you that you're going to win. You're supposed to have faith. If the Lord is with you, you're going to win every battle. It don't matter what the odds are. It don't mean if it's 20 against that. What's the scripture say? One person would chase 30 or something.
A thousand.
Something. Yeah, that's crazy. That's why the only two that had faith was Joshua and Caleb. And so they was the only ones that were allowed to go to the promised land because they showed great faith. You know what I mean? And they believed what the Lord said. And they came back. Everybody else was saying the Canaanites and the giants were too great. But Joshua was like, nah, we got this. You know what I mean? He said, we can do this. That's the spirit we in. Go ahead. Oh, yes.
Yeah. Leviticus 26:7. And ye shall chase your enemies, they shall fall.
Oh, hold on a second. God damn it. What is this? Oh, no, go ahead. Go ahead. Go. I still got 4 minutes until it starts over.
Leviticus 26:7. Ye shall chase your enemies, and they shall fall before you by the sword. And 5 of you shall chase 100.
Yeah, 5 shall chase 100.
And 100 of you shall put 10,000 to flight.
Damn, one, just 100. So that's going up against overwhelming odds. And it's saying that we would just totally destroy. What is that, 100 and chase what, 10,000?
And 10,000.
Yeah, 100.
And 100 of you shall chase 10,000.
Yeah, because if the Lord is with us, we're unstoppable. That's what you fools don't get. That's because these people lack faith. They got no faith. You know what I'm saying? That's why when David went up against Goliath, this motherfucker, Goliath was goddamn 20 feet tall. You know what I mean? Probably maybe taller. He killed his ass with a slingshot. And that really happened. It's in the history book. People are, oh, that's bullshit. That didn't happen. Well, there's a special, there's a special punishment for a person like that. You know what I mean?
He even said, you come out with spirits.
Hey, let's get it. Let's get it. I love it. I love reading. Second, 1 Samuel 16, I think, or 17.
Rock sunk in the
I love reading that scripture, man.
That's like, what people don't notice. This rock sunk into it.
Sunk into it. It's like he got shot with a pistol. You know what I mean? Yeah. Artillery shell, right? That's a big ass head, too. You know, he had a thicker skull than the average person. Man, he sunk that damn stone right in the battle was over in minutes. You know what I mean? The rest of Israel was terrified. Everybody.
Let me read this before we get that.
Oh, go ahead.
Jeremiah 46:10. For this is the day of the Lord, power of hosts, a day of vengeance that he may avenge him of his adversary.
Yeah, so the Lord is all about revenge. The Lord's all about taking vengeance. You know what I mean? And the Lord's all about his promise and keeping his word.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Yeah. That he may avenge him of his adversaries. And the sword shall devour, and it shall be satiated and made drunk with their blood. For the Lord power of hosts hath a sacrifice in the north country by the river Euphrates.
That's a good scripture. Yeah, so the Lord's all about revenge, and he's going to use us to carry out some of that vengeance too. When that time comes, the Lord's going to raise up his army, that holy army. Why do you think they said the Lord is a man of war? The Lord is his name. Why does the Bible call him the Lord of hosts? Sabaoth. That means the Lord of the armies. You know what I mean? And the Lord is going to raise up that army, the elect, that 144,000. And like the scripture said, just 100 of us is going to put to flight 10,000.
Look at this way. 144,000 is going to conquer 8 billion.
Yep. The whole damn planet.
Right. Now, that's some numbers right there.
That's some numbers for your ass.
For real. Shit.
Yeah, just think about it. If 100 can put to flight 10,000, what could 144,000 do?
That's it, the whole planet.
Oh, shit, this shit's gone.
The whole planet, the whole universe. The whole cosmos.
All right, hold on, I'm about to start a new